welcome to this edition of Backstage Pass with Lia Chang.
I wanted to create films that foster inclusion and diversity on both sides of the camera, so I started my own production company, Bev's Girl Films. On this episode of Backstage Pass with Lia Chang, I'm sharing three of our short films written and directed by Garth Kravits, When the World Was Young, Belongingness, and Rom-Com Gone Wrong.
Julie, my love, tonight was magical. If only life and all its complications would allow us to be together. But we both know that sadly, now is not our time. Let's make a promise that if in 10 years we find ourselves free to be with one another, then we'll meet in the park at our spot, wear that dress you wore tonight, and I'll wear the suit I had on. If we're meant to be, then that night, 10 years from tonight, will be the beginning of our lives. Finally, together and in love, forevermore. Love, Glenn.
Julie?
Glenn! You're here.
Yeah, I was just, wow. You look amazing. How have you been? I haven't seen you in, what, like 9 years?
10. It's been 10 years, Glenn. To the day.
Oh, right! That's why you're here, in the dress. I totally had this whole thing in my phone, on my calendar, but I changed carriers, and I'm doing the whole watch thing, and I guess, you know. But I mean, wow, you really look amazing. Are you, you know, seeing anyone?
No, I'm here, in the dress. I bought flowers.
Right, yes, of course.
You know, Glenn, I have thought about you and this moment for the last 10 years. Not every day, but when something would happen, a breakup or a rough patch, I would read your note. And I would smile. And it would make me feel so good. And I would count the years that were left until this moment for us to be together in love forevermore.
You know what? I still live just a few blocks away from here. I can go home real quick, take a shower. Oh, I do have that Bumble date tonight, which I will totally cancel and come right back here to our spot wearing the blue suit. Gray suit?
This is over.
Was it the tan and khaki suit? Because I'd have to swing by the dry cleaners to pick it up.
Yo, bro. You want a hit?
No thanks.
Julie!
Oh, hi, Glenn. Ready to go?
Yeah. Nice suit.
Thank you. Just me.
Benjamin!
Good flight?
Paris to London, no. I slept from London to New York. Thank you, Ambien. Ama!
Miss Audrey! Your brother tells me you're only staying the weekend.
I know. There's an event that can't happen without me there, but I'll be back for the holidays.
We'll take what we can get. Now, let me take a look at you. Perfect as always.
Oh, please, I'm a mess.
I'll put your things in your room. There's tea.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, I love this scarf.
Keep it. It's the perfect color for you.
No.
Ama, I insist.
Well, thank you, dear.
Generous of you?
No. It was last season. Besides, now I'm off the hook for her Christmas present.
Of course.
Audrey!
Hello, Mother.
I thought you had violin until 5:30.
I haven't had violin since the 8th grade, Mother.
I know that. I was just excited that you're home. Come, sit.
What was that? You said she wasn't that bad.
She's fine. She's tired. We'll learn more when we meet the doctor tomorrow.
You know, you didn't have to come at all. I had no intention of disrupting anybody's schedule.
The doctor told you it was important they should come, and I knew you wouldn't ask yourself.
She works behind my back. I would hide my jewelry if I were you.
Oh, hush.
See how she talks to me?
I'm going to take a shower and get settled.
Audrey.
Yes, Mother?
You don't have to stay if you don't want to.
I know.
So this tiny thing is what wins you a James Beard Award?
That's the first course, Mom. The rest gets bigger, I promise.
Well, I sent a friend and her husband to your newest place on Restaurant Row. I forgot the name.
Botanical.
Botanical. Yes. Well, they had to wait an hour before being seated, and I said I would talk to you about it.
I will pass that along to the team, Mom. It's not really something that I'm in...
Okay. Did you ever get that congratulations gift I sent you? I had Tammy send it to your office.
Yes, I did. Thank you. And your assistant still doesn't seem to remember that I don't do bow ties.
It was Tom Ford.
Well, that changes everything.
I think I'll turn on some music.
Why don't you use the Alexa that I set up for you last time? That way you won't even have to get up.
Well, I never got a thank you note from you.
You're not the only one who's busy, Audrey.
I didn't take anything of yours.
No, that is mine.
No.
It was in my
drawer.
Don't
accuse me of something like that.
I don't trust you.
What happened? What's going on?
She says I stole her scarf. She's just confused.
Mother, I gave her that scarf.
I don't want you wearing that scarf in my house. I said take it off.
Mom. Ama, leave it. It's fine.
It is not fine. Nothing is fine. None of this is fine. I don't know what this is fine. There's nothing fine. I don't know what's happening.
come here on Sundays.
It was quiet. We both liked that. And we could watch the people when they left the church around the corner. And these women had these amazing hats. I was never a hat girl.
Right. I remember that photo of Auntie Lee with you in it, and she was wearing this great hat.
It's called a cloche. Where was that picture taken?
What picture?
The one in the hallway.
Oh, yes, that's right. That must have been in the hallway.
It was in front of the Village Vanguard, Mom. The two of you were out to celebrate your graduation, right?
Oh, right, yes. We liked it here. It was quiet and we could watch the people. And she always drank mimosas. I was a Bellini girl.
Right, with peach nectar only, no schnapps.
I never liked schnapps.
You like peppermint schnapps at Christmas, though.
I need to go to the ladies' room.
I'll take you.
I'm fine.
The doctor says you're supposed to let her remember. You're telling her everything.
I'm just trying to be helpful. I don't know. I don't like watching her struggle.
Ugh, I hate this.
Don't worry. You're on a flight tomorrow. You won't have to deal with it until Christmas.
Oh, because the prodigal son is going to take care of everything?
I didn't say I was going to take care of everything.
Well, what are you saying?
Should she be in there alone?
I offered to take her. You saw, she bit my head off. Fine. She's not there.
And I must admit, I like it quite well. It's something to be the darling of all, a grand femme fatale, the belle of the ball. There's nothing so gay as life in Paris. There's no other person I'd rather be. I love what I do. I love what I see. Yet where is that schoolgirl who used to be me? Oh, the apple tree.
Thank you.
How did we never know about this? I mean, your voice. And look at you.
I did look good.
Good? You look more than good. What is this?
Oh, Harper's Bazaar. That photographer, he's very famous.
Richard Avedon?
Yes.
You were photographed by Richard Avedon. You forgot to mention it to me, Mother. This is amazing. I love it.
So what happened?
I got married to your father and I had you. Your father thought I should focus on more important things.
And you just gave it all up?
I made a choice. And it was the right choice. I think we all know we're better off by making that choice.
No one's questioning your choices, Mom. It's just, I wish I could have heard you sing all these years.
small. I did sing to you when you were falling asleep. I guess you were too young to remember.
I remember.
You remember Mom singing to you?
Yes, I do. But when I remember it, it was Ama.
No. No, I was the singer. She was the dancer. And she was very good.
This is nice, Mom. I want to hear more about the nightclubs.
I want to hear more about this dress.
La la la, la la la, la la la, la la.
Benny, go back to bed. Everybody's excited about your new baby sister, but you have school tomorrow. Love you.
What the hell was that?
I don't know. It was kind of sweet.
She didn't know where she was. She didn't know when it was. I didn't even know what to do.
I get it.
She didn't come into your room in the middle of the night and sing you a creepy lullaby at the end of your bed.
Audrey.
I can't see her like this. It's only gonna get worse.
Yes, it's going to get worse. And yes, it's going to be hard. I'm going back to San Francisco for a few days, but then I'm moving back into the house. The doctor was right. It's better if she has us with her. I'm gonna handle work from here for a little while. And you know, you can too, but only if you want to. I can't make you stay. I didn't know you play piano.
Oh, Arthur. Don't be silly. You said that's why you fell for me.
Mom. Mommy. It's Ben.
You came into the five spot to get out of the heat. And I know it was summer because you were wearing short sleeves.
I don't remember that. Jenny, tell me what happened.
I played in the five spot on afternoons mostly, and it was almost empty, so you sat right next to the piano, and you ordered a lemonade. I'll never forget that. And then when I finished my set, you said, you said, Arthur, I can't remember what you said.
It's okay.
Damn it. Tell me what you said.
Play for me. Maybe if you play for me, maybe I'll remember.
Yes. Will you sing for me? If I play for you, will you sing for me?
I'll try.
On the apple trees, blossoms in looking at the sky till the stars were strung.
Only last July,
when the world was young.
Thrilled and delighted when our film won two awards at the 2021 Disorient Asian American Film Festival of Oregon, the 2021 Disorient Film Audience Choice Award for Best Short Narrative, and a 2021 Disorient Inspirational Artist Award for our beloved star, Virginia Wing.
Thank you for joining me for this edition of Backstage Pass with Lia Chang. Until next time.